Good evening, and welcome to the HAR-BER Wildcat Sports Network. I'm Nick Luttrell. On tonight's episode, we look back at the Wildcats' first conference game against Bentonville, plus a reflection on homecoming. We also catch up with Max Pena and Billy Tillery. Plus, you guessed it, take a look at the Lady Wildcat volleyball team and their season so far, as they have started the second half of conference play. HAR-BER and Heritage are warming up out in the field right now. It's Friday, October 4th, 2019, and the Wildcat Sports Network starts right now. Here in the studio, as always, to start things off is Coach Wood. Coach, conference play opened up last week. You guys faced a very difficult Bentonville team. What were some of your impressions from that game?
Well, yeah, I mean, going back to the game, our guys, you know, they played hard. They gave great effort. But bottom line is we came up short in two of the three phases, our kicking game. Ran a fake punt, was not successful on that. We had a punt blocked and gave them short field on both of those. And Bentonville came away with points. Offensively, they turned the ball over five times. I thought our defense did a fantastic job. They were given a short field all night, and they held them to four field goals, which I thought was really a nice job by them. I think the big takeaway from the game, to be honest with you, is Bentonville just kind of set back. They played sound football, and they let us kind of make the mistakes to decide the game. And, you know, as you go back and you reflect through the week and reflect through the weekend on, you know, football games, are you win them during the week. And what you put in during the week shows on a Friday night. And to be honest with you, that's our play offensively, our play in the kicking game, that falls back on me. And, you know, when I reflect back, we weren't as detail-driven in practice. We weren't as focused to being perfect on doing the little things right. And when you don't hold your guys to the standard of, you know, we're going to be perfect when we make mistakes, we're going to correct them now. And so, you know, our kids played hard. And it's my job as the head football coach here to make sure that we execute better, because when your kids give their heart and soul the way they did, and to come up short in a game like that, when I can reflect back on how we practiced and the accountability within practice, I think that's the defining moment. It's not on the kids, it's on me for, you know, allowing a few things slide with the details of how we prepare each week. And we went into this week focused on the details, because I realized that was the biggest issue. It wasn't kids' decision-making, it wasn't effort, it wasn't all that. It goes back to how you practice and how you prepare and your mindset there. I didn't do a good enough job as a head coach, and our guys competed, just came up short.
Yeah. Now, as a spectator, I've seen games where one team is just flat out better than the other. But between Bentonville and HAR-BER, it seemed pretty evenly matched. It may have come down to turnovers. Was that your consensus as well?
Yeah, I mean, you know, you get into the game, it's Coach Grant and that staff and those kids, they played hard and they executed. Do I believe the best team won on Friday night? No, I don't. And but the better prepared team, the more disciplined team won. And that's really what decides elite games. And that's what gives them the advantage over us. That's why they're 1-0 in conference. We're 0-1 because Coach Grant and his staff did a better job than me than getting our boys ready to play. And they deserve it. But would I play them again? Yes, I would.
Now, speaking of turnovers, you guys had five in that game. Moving forward to this week, how do you guys correct that issue?
Well, I mean, again, it goes into practice. It's the details of practice. I mean, you've got to make sure, you know, in each five-minute period when we're working, that we're holding our guys, and there's, you know, reminders that, hey, that's not high-level winning football. You know, if we miss a throw or we miss a blocking assignment, we've got to point that out and get it corrected then. Not just tell them, hey, and then move on, but make sure we've got it corrected, and then we move on to the next play. And I think we go into this week, and I think our guys are going to play really clean football tonight. I think they're going to do a really good job. And because us as a coaching staff, we harped and we focused on the details of what needed to be corrected, so the young men are better prepared to play tonight. And again, it's not a kid-driven deal. It's a coach-driven deal.
Now, three interceptions for Blaze against Bentonville. Mm-hmm. What's something that you tell him as a coach to maybe put some confidence in him for tonight's game?
Yeah, Blaze is going to be fine. You know, the good part about Blaze is, you know, he doesn't take things personal. And, you know, he gets coached up and he moves on to the next rep. He wants to do well. He you know, he's a guy that loves his teammates. And so Blaze is going to be just fine. It's just learn from it. And, you know, I mean, we were on the field on Wednesday morning, and there was a situation that kind of mimicked one of the turnovers Friday night. And, you know, I told Blaze, Blaze is sitting on you. We didn't do a good enough job teaching you in this moment how to handle this moment when you see this type of pressure. That's on us. It's not on Blaze. And we got to use that as an opportunity to teach Blaze. And so he's better prepared for when that moment happens again, because I'd like to say we're going to play perfect football and we're going to block everybody and every throw is going to be great or we're going to make every tackle. But I mean, we're all human. There's a lot of mistakes in the game of football and the details of it. And so it's my job to make sure I've put Blaze in those situations where he's seen it, so it's not new to him and he knows how to handle that situation. So Blaze is going to be just fine.
For sure. Now, one of the positives I did see is that although Bentonville scored 35 points, your defense did a phenomenal job. Every time they would get good field position and get in our red zone, our defense would stop them, hold them to a field goal. How big do you think they were to keep you guys in the game last
night? That was huge. I mean, we've seen a major growth in our defense each week, and we talked about it last week. You know, if our kicking game is sound and we flip the field and we don't play with a short field, which I talked about before, if we don't turn the ball over and we make them have to drive the ball, I mean, I don't know if they score 35. And our defense was put in a bad situation, I mean, multiple times. And each time they had the right mindset. I mean, they didn't blame nobody. They didn't complain. They didn't get their heads down. They just went out and played football, held them to field goals. They kept giving our offense a chance to get us in the game. And that's why even towards the very end with 5 minutes left in the game, we had a chance. I mean, until our last fumble. I mean, we were in it. We were right there to be able to get within striking distance. That's all. You got to contribute that all to how our defense just bowed up and held them to field goals so we could stay in striking distance.
Now, Billy Tillery is someone who we talked to later. Had a big game, 12 tackles, probably his biggest game as a Wildcat. Talk about his progression over the past few weeks, over the offseason, just him being a junior and the leadership that he possesses.
Yeah, Billy, you know, he plays the game hard, and he's a physical player. He did a good job on his reads, flowing to the ball, getting downhill, not hesitating. And that's what we've got to see. You know, he's a kid that played for us as a sophomore, and he's back as a junior. He's got that another year experience. Game should be slowing down for him, so he can even play faster. But he has the right mindset. I mean, he's a tough-nosed, hard kid, and he gets after it, and he does everything we ask.
Coach, thanks for joining us. If you missed last Friday night's game, as always, our team was standing by to bring you the highlights. Take a look at the recap from conference opener, HAR-BER versus Bentonville.
Welcome to Wildcat Friday night, and homecoming 2019 here at Wildcat Stadium on the campus of HAR-BER High School in beautiful Springdale, Arkansas. Throws deep to the left, got a man over the middle, incomplete. Jawan Boyd there just breaks it up. Cross back look to the right, incomplete, turnover, four and out for the Tigers. Bottom one to the top, hands it off up the middle looking for the room. And he gets it, that's a touchdown for the Tigers. Inside of the screen, switches back. Wood draws back, looks for Wood, complete by Wood, first down for the Wildcats. Takes the handoff, Witchett rolls to the top. Comeback route for Seawood, Seawood out of bounds at the 9, first down, Wildcats. Two to the top, one to the bottom, Burns will line up next to Witchett, he's back at shotgun. Hands it off to Burns, Burns in for a touchdown, HAR-BER Wildcats. Is down, a kick is up, and it is barely good. I did not think that made it through the upright. Hands it off on the right-hand edge. Good containment, but he's going to break for a first down. He's going to go for a touchdown. Wood at the top, Seawood at the bottom. Burns next to Witchin. Takes a snap, drops back. Heaves it deep for Wood. They're going to make him go up for it. He catches it down at the 10-yard line. He just wanted it more than the other two guys. 1:21 left to go. Inside the Storm's orthodontics, there's Burns. Touchdown, HAR-BER Wildcats. Jay Burns on the 1 yard carry. Hands it off on the right hand edge. And he's gonna score a touchdown. Bottom Wood to the top. Burns behind Witchett. Witchett takes the snap. Drops back, looks for Wood, fires, in and
touchdown!
Hands it off on the left-hand side. Again, just smashed up. There's Baker, there's Wright. By 3, 21-24, Witchett back at shotgun. Drops down, gets the snap, he's gonna be flushed out of the pocket, he's gonna throw it into the stands. 40-yard kick. The wind is out of the south, so in his face, but it is behind the indoor field, and that kick is up, and it is good. And the kick is good.
Win or lose, we will bring you the highlights for every game, so you can relive every moment right here on WCSN. Now tonight, our Wildcats will take on Rogers Heritage, and though they haven't won a game in almost 2 years, they have a new coach and are more hungry than ever for a victory. Tune in after WCSN to see that matchup. Let's take a quick commercial break, but don't go anywhere. We have Billy Tilley and Max Pena, and also special guest Natalie Williams will be in the studio. WCSN will be right back.
Presented by McLarty Daniel.
There was an idea
to bring together a group of remarkable people to see if we could become something more. So when they needed us, we could fight the battles
that they never could.
Largest pre-owned inventory in Northwest Arkansas.
Whatever you're looking for, you'll find it in McLarty Daniel Country. With 800 pre-owned vehicles at six giant locations in Bentonville and Springdale, there's something for everyone. Plus,
at McLarty Daniel, you're protected.
Drive worry-free for 7 years or 200,000 miles with the MD pre-owned Advantage. And when it's time to sell your car, we're ready to buy it, even if you don't buy from us. Have you visited McLarty Daniel Country yet?
Visit us online at McLartyDaniel.com.
We came to Arvest Bank to see what makes it different.
It's a community bank that really reaches out to the customers to make them feel special. I feel special every time I come in here.
They want to be involved in the community. They want to be part of the community.
They support our university, our athletic department.
They've told us that they could have a fleet of volunteers there to help this year if we needed.
I see them at a lot of our Hispanic community events that we do.
I can't think of another bank in the city that has such a big community presence as Arvest.
Arvest Bank, our customers say it best.
Our 30 minutes or less ER service pledge means you'll find less waiting where it matters most. Faster care in the emergency room. The 30 minutes or less ER service pledge at Northwest Health System, Bentonville, and Springdale.
At Jimmy John's, we know how much you care about freshness, quality, and value. We want your sandwiches to arrive freaky fast, so they're freaky fresh. That's why we only deliver within 5 minutes of our stores, and not farther.
He's new.
If you're in the zone or in the store, you can get a freaky fresh sandwich. Jimmy John's, because sandwich.
For over 20 years, Community Clinic has served Washington County with quality and affordable health care. With three wellness centers in Springdale, located at Jones, George, and Elmdale Elementary, our services include primary care, pediatrics, prenatal, behavioral health, and physical therapy. We offer services in English, Spanish, and Marseillaise so that we can help your family. The Community Clinic. Healthy people, healthy community.
Hey Riley, will you come in here real quick?
Yeah man, one sec.
Hey, so I'm just I'm looking through some film myself, and you know, I was thinking if you would take a look at this. In other news, our Wildcat baseball team is going to face off against the...
Hold up. What are you doing with your arm? I mean, you're distracting the audience by your chicken dance.
Well, I just thought it would, you know, bring more attention to myself.
No.
Okay. Now we're going to talk about softball. The softball team, you know, they did okay this year, and it's...
This is totally unprofessional. You're just spinning in circles and... It's not looking good, man.
Well, I thought that maybe the different angles would be kind of cool.
No.
Welcome back, guys. Here we are back in the Wildcat Sports Network studio. We're going to be talking a little bit about the soccer.
Oh, my goodness. I'm done. That's what I have.
Welcome back. Joining us in the studio is none other than Max Pena. Max, Friday night you guys had a tough loss against a very talented Bentonville team. Looking back and throughout the course of this week, what can you learn the most from this loss?
Something we can take away from this loss that we had, something we can learn is that offensively, we need to execute on plays better. Just everyone focusing on their job and just execute what we have to do.
Yeah. Now you play fullback. Talk about just how good that those Tigers linebackers were.
Bentonville has some good, well-coached, fast, solid linebackers. They're physical and, every play, it's a physical game with them.
Yeah. Now, personally, you made the transition into a fullback. What has it been like moving into that position?
Playing fullback, I enjoy it. It's a lot of contact, so, meeting a linebacker is picking up oncoming blitz, so it's fun, it's a physical position. I like it.
Yeah. Now you're very unique in that you do the kickoffs and the field goals for the Wildcats. Tell us with your background in soccer and kind of what that's been like.
So throughout high school I played soccer and the fundamentals is very similar to kicking a field goal, so just applied what I do in soccer. And then with Coach Simpson, polished some things up and just kick the ball down the field.
Yeah. Now tonight you'll face off against Rogers Heritage. What can we expect out of the War Eagle defense?
So the War Eagle defense, we'll be expecting a lot of man, so we'll probably have a lot of mismatches around the field and just find a weakness and go after it.
Max, thanks for joining us and good luck tonight.
All right, thank you.
Let's take another quick commercial break, but coming up next, Natalie Williams joins us in the studio. Don't go anywhere, you're watching the Wildcat Sports Network.
Dominators.
First Security is here. Only here. So that means we're here. Here. And here. Even here. And definitely here. Because here is where we want to be for you. First Security Bank, only in Arkansas.
Welcome home to Lindsay Living. Affordable rates, available on-site management, attitudes of service, and amenities unmatched make residents love where they live and play. From value-packed basic apartments to resort-style living on golf courses, we manage options to fit your needs and wants. Apply online at lindsaymanagement.com for locations throughout Arkansas and in surrounding states.
At Northwest Health, you can check in online for urgent care and ER visits. This simple step lets you pick a time that's convenient and saves your spot in line before you arrive. It's our new approach to the waiting room. Visit mynorthwestanycare.com.
Ballpark Franks got their start in 1957, right here in the ballpark. And with the taste of 100% Angus beef, passed down from one generation to the next, they soon became a tradition everywhere, bringing on the feeling of summer in every bite. Ballpark Franks, bring on summer.
At Jimmy John's, we want your sandwich to arrive freaky fresh, so we only deliver within 5 minutes of our stores, and not farther.
He's new.
Order at jimmyjohns.com, because sandwich.
Choose the Wellness Centers at Springdale Schools. The Wellness Centers in Springdale are perfect for students and teachers. Teachers can go during their planning period, and parents don't have to miss work for students to receive medical care. Offering sports physicals, kindergarten physicals, vaccinations, well child checks, acute care, and more. Wellness centers are located at a school near you. Wellness centers in Springdale Schools, we are your medical home.
Hey Nick, catch.
Thank you.
Welcome back. Last week was the HAR-BER High School homecoming, and even though it ended with a loss against Bentonville, there was still plenty to celebrate. There was homecoming parade on Thursday, which we broadcasted live for the second straight year. There was a HAR-BER High School carnival, the homecoming simply Friday afternoon, which was also live, the coronation before the game on Friday, not to mention the dance Saturday night. Definitely a week to remember at HAR-BER. Our team was standing by to bring you all the highlights, plus catch up to this year's homecoming queen. Here's the story.
Homecoming week is a busy time for both students and teachers at HAR-BER High School, filled with dressing up for Spirit Week, carnival fundraisers, and a parade for the whole community to enjoy.
And I really just like to dress up just to kind of like promote like HAR-BER High School and like really just promote like the event that's going on, just kind of show school spirit and try to be a leader to others. Really the parade yesterday, that's awesome. And I really encourage kids to get involved in school and in clubs so they can get on the float. And the carnival was awesome too, especially like the car bashing thing. Thought it was really cool. And then the homecoming coronation, that's always really a neat thing just to kind of find out like who's gonna be it.
Students participated all week in festivities such as Spirit Week and running carnival games that all led up to the football game Friday and the dance Saturday night.
So I like dressing up for Spirit Week because me and all my friends do it and it gets us ready for the homecoming football game and the dance. I was actually on the DECA float for the parade and it was super fun to go by Bernice Young. I went to elementary school there, so it was fun to see everyone. As a senior, I like to dress up because I want to encourage the underclassmen to dress up and carry on the legacy once all of the seniors are gone.
All this is leading up to the game tonight against Bentonville. Student section always is so awesome and just so fun, just really shows school spirit.
The festivities of homecoming wouldn't be possible without student council sponsor Rachel Cockrell and the immense amount of work that student council put in, not only this week, but the entire year.
I mean, it's fun to be a part of something. And so I think when the students like join in on Spirit Week, then they feel like they're a part of something that's happening at the school. But yeah, just making them feel like they're part of the school and they don't just have to show up here, you know, because they have to.
Ending the week with a high-energy football game against Bentonville and a dance enjoyable for all, HAR-BER Homecoming was definitely one to remember. For HBWN, I'm Sam Lewandowski.
Congratulations to senior Felicity Rubio on being crowned this year's Homecoming Queen. Let's take a minute to hear from a few more of our sponsors, but up next, Natalie Williams is in the studio to catch up on the Lady Wildcats as they have already started the second half of conference play. Don't go anywhere, the Wildcat Sports Network will be right back.
If you want fast, easy, and affordable service, visit McLarty Daniel.
Keep your vehicle running like new in our state-of-the-art service facilities. We know your time is valuable. Our factory-certified technicians with decades of experience will get you in and out and back on the road quickly. We service all makes and models at our six convenient locations in Bentonville and Springdale, open 6 days a week.
Visit McLartyDaniel.com to schedule your service appointment today.
Keep your sandwich freaky fresh, Jimmy John's only delivers within 5 minutes of the store, and not farther. It's nothing personal. It's because sandwich.
First Security is here. Only here. So that means we're here. Here. And here. Even here. And definitely here. Because here is where we want to be for you. First Security Bank, only in Arkansas.
Ozarks Go from Ozarks Electric Cooperative is leading the fiber revolution. Connecting the divide with high-speed broadband access to close that gap. From cloud to cloud, post to post. From downtown to way out of town. To connect our customers to a world of blazing speed and access to absolutely everywhere. It's our customers connected and energized with Ozarks Go.
At Northwest Health, we've made it easier to schedule a doctor's appointment. Online scheduling for our primary care physicians lets you make an appointment at any time from anywhere. It's the new way to book your next visit. MyNorthwestAnyCare.com.
Hey Northwest Arkansas, Lara here at Sam's Furniture. If you're looking for new furniture, we have over 170,000 square feet selection at everyday low prices and same day delivery available. But the best part is that we love to serve our community. So when you buy at Sam's, part of your purchase goes to support one of the many amazing organizations that we have been blessed to partner with. Serving others, especially those in need, is our culture here, and we hope that you'll be a part of that too. Arkansas's largest furniture destination. Get it at Sam's.
On the counter, find a hole. Garrett inside the five. Touchdown, Springdale. Good!
Wide open, Trey Smith. Touchdown, HAR-BER Wildcats.
For WCSN, I'm Ashlyn Grace Brothers.
No, you gotta own it. You gotta be like, for WCSN, I'm Ashlyn Grace Brothers.
For WCSN, I'm Ashlyn Grace Brothers.
No, I'm Ashlyn Grace Brothers.
Okay, I'm Ashlyn Grace Brothers.
Better.
Yeah, but don't you think I should add like some...
Ew! Red yellow card!
Is she gonna be okay?
Yeah, they always do this.
Okay, so you said, I'm Ashlyn Grace Brothers.
Yeah, just
No. But don't you think that I should add something like, that's the way the cookie crumbles, or, ooh, okay, good one. I could say something like,
No, just one more time.
Okay, for WCSN, I'm Ashlyn Grace Brothers.
Much better.
Welcome back. Joining us in the studio now is senior volleyball player Natalie Williams. Natalie, after the first half of conference season, will you tell us a little about your thoughts and what it's been like the past few weeks?
Yeah, so the past few weeks have been really testing us as a team. We've had multiple tournaments as well as two conference games every week. So we played at the Bentonville tournament, and we saw a lot of tough teams from our side of the conference and the other side of the conference that we will see later in the state tournament. And then at Jinx, we played a few weekends ago. It was best 3 out of 5, and 3 of our games went to 5 sets. So it really tested us to just push through our tiredness and push through our not giving up and to work hard, which we actually overcame and won the Bentonville tournament and beat the 19th team in the nation.
Yeah. Now Thursday, you guys face off against Fayetteville. They handed you guys your first loss of the conference season. What could you guys learn from that loss?
Yeah, so throughout that game, I feel like we are all just in our own heads. So I feel like through that game, we just learned that we need to lean on each other and support each other to do better.
Now next time you guys see them, it'll be almost a bigger game, October 22nd. This time it'll be at home. What can you guys do differently to get the win this time?
So as our last conference game of the season, I'm excited to play Fayetteville because I feel like throughout the season we've just played multiple games that have pushed us, and I feel like we are ready to play them and that we will be able to just work harder and to support each other through this game.
Now, Natalie, last year you were a setter. Because of the need of the team, you transitioned. You're now a right-side hitter for the Wildcats. What has that transition been like for you?
It's been actually a really different transition because I'm used to being a setter and getting a ton of balls. So being a hitter now, it's really taught me that it's really showed me that I need to be equally working as hard because I know how hard it is to be a setter, and it pushes me to work hard because I know how hard it is to get a good pass and get a good set.
Now let's talk about Bentonville. You started the second half of the conference season at Bentonville. Talk to us a little bit about that game.
So coming off from the loss from Fayetteville, I feel like we're a little down on ourselves. But throughout the game, in the beginning of the third set, I feel like we started out with the new energy that helped us, and we were able to just stay as a team and work harder throughout the game. And we actually took Bentonville to 4. We lost, but I feel like we worked really hard and played as a team.
Now, your next game, you guys will play at Springdale, obviously a huge rivalry game. What can you guys do to win this one?
This game is really big for us, especially since it is our hometown rival and at Springdale. So I feel like throughout this game, we just need to play our own game and play together and just keep the high energy throughout the game.
Natalie, thanks for being here and good luck.
Thanks for having me.
Now, staying on the same page, our goal this year is to introduce you to as many of these Lady Wildcat volleyball players as possible. And so this week, our WCSN team went courtside to follow one of the newest members of the team, Caitlin Coombs, and her contribution to the Wildcats' success. Take a look.
HAR-BER Volleyball is a force to be reckoned with this conference season, with key players like Caitlin Coombs, who have solidified their spots through hard work and training, and definitely deserve your eye during the game.
I think we've done a really good job of mentally, just like, because she gets really, like, worked up.
because she wants to win so bad. So I feel like we've kind of calmed her a little bit in her play, and it's made her better out on the court. She doesn't make a lot of errors. She's really smart, and her volleyball IQ really takes her to that next level, and the fact that she's played for a really long time.
Acknowledged by all, Kaylin has high potential entering the end of high school, but challenges don't come without growth that she has seen within herself.
Some of the accomplishments I've had is just like becoming like a good teammate. I feel like I've grown in that aspect of the game, and like just improving my skill sets and like expanding them. So like becoming just more arranged around the court. And I just feel like I've like grown my vocal voice as well, because that's one thing I've really struggled with. And Coach Lloyd and Coach White have helped me so much through that. And I just can't wait for the next 3 years to keep improving.
Teammates have allowed Kaylin as a sophomore to feel comfortable, welcome, and successful within the team, on and off the court.
Kaylin's a really great person. I love being friends with her. She's awesome on and off the court to everyone she meets. She's super humble, so we all love being around her. And it's just really fun getting to play with her and getting to know her. I see her going really far. Her passion and her main focus is volleyball. So like she's gonna go everywhere she wants to go. And even if she doesn't know where that is right now, like she's gonna get there.
Continue supporting your Wildcat volleyball team. You can see them on the 8th against Springdale, and on the 10th at home against Bentonville West. From WCSN, I'm Caleb Palfreyman.
Next week is Rivalry Week, as both Lady Wildcat volleyball team and our varsity football team will take on Springdale. It'll be a big week with lots of activities. Be sure to show your spirit and support HAR-BER. On another note, both the voice of the Wildcats and the voice of the Bulldogs will be teaming up next week to co-host WCSN, as well as commentate the Friday night game, as I take a small hiatus to participate in a state golf tournament. Good luck to me. Let's take another quick commercial break, but stay tuned. Up next is Billy Tillery, as well as a story about receiver Micah Seawood. Don't change the channel. The Wildcat Sports Network will be right back.
First Security is here, only here. So that means we're here, here, and here. Even here, and definitely here. Because here is where we want to be. For you, First Security Bank, only in Arkansas.
Nothing says game day like good friends and great food. And at Slim Chickens, we know great food. From our 100% all-natural chicken tenders, fresh-made wings served with house sauces, to delicious chicken sandwiches, crisp salads, southern sides, and desserts you just can't get anywhere else. At Slim's, we have the food you love, made fresh for the people you care about. Dine in, drive through, or order online. Slim Chickens. Fresh, delicious chicken.
Welcome home to Lindsay Living. From value-packed basic apartments with appliances and washers and dryers to resort-style apartment living on golf courses with fabulous amenities, you'll love where you live and play. Visit lindsaymanagement.com to apply online and see photos, rates, and floor plans for all locations we manage throughout Arkansas and in surrounding states.
I need new tires. What size of tire do I need? Will they have my size? Do I need an appointment? When can I get in? How long will that take? Can I drop my car off? Do I have to wait there? What will I do with my kids? Will they have a tire that fits my budget?
Does buying tires have your head spinning? At Tire Tracks, we have all the answers built on over 20 years of local service. With 3 convenient locations in Northwest Arkansas and over 25 highly skilled technicians, we can answer all your questions and keep your head from spinning.
I thought I had it all. I was a captain of industry, a master of my domain. And then I learned that Jimmy John's only delivers 5 minutes from their stores to maximize freshness. I live 6 minutes away. Extra mayo. My entire life wasted.
When accidents happen, our 30 minutes or less ER service pledge can mean less waiting and faster care. The 30 minutes or less ER service pledge at Northwest Health System Bentonville and Springdale.
During the Great Depression, nothing came easy.
But with just 5 cents, an old truck, and a load of hay, John Tyson and his family found a way to deliver quality chicken to other hardworking people. Today, Tyson continues to find new ways to help put a chicken in every pot. Because people deserve farm-raised chicken of the highest quality. At Tyson, we remain committed to this simple promise, to always keep it real, to always keep it Tyson.
So, Sane Matthews, his lightning fast speed.
No. He's got explosive speed.
Dude's lightning fast.
Sane, would you describe your speed as explosive or lightning fast?
What?
Dude, I'm telling you, he's explosive.
Lightning fast.
What's that? Lightning fast.
Lightning fast.
Yeah.
Welcome back. Here with us now is Billy Tillery. Billy, on Friday, you guys suffered a tough loss against a very talented Bentonville team, one of the best in the state. Over the course of this week, what are some key reflecting points from that game?
Basically, just that we have to fix our mistakes that we made. We got away from our fundamentals that our coach had been teaching us. And there was a lot of guys that weren't really into the game. We just had to make sure that everybody's kind of connected and we're all playing as one team.
Now, although your team lost, there are definitely some bright moments for you. You led the team with 12 total tackles. What can you attribute the success to?
Basically, just all the guys around me on the defense. We were all just playing as a whole, basically. And before the game, I spent a lot of time with my D linemen. We were just talking about how we have to fit the guys up perfectly and how we just have to stick to our assignments and what we've been talking about all week with our coaches. And I think we did a good job on getting our kicks right and all of our angles. And over the past couple of weeks, we've been working a lot on our tackling with our coaches and basically just biting the ball and all the fundamentals that we've been taught over the years.
Now, we talked about this a little bit with Coach Wood. It never seemed like you guys were really outmatched. It seemed like a pretty evenly matched game. And it came down to turnovers, really. What are your thoughts on this?
Basically, we got to stay in the game. We can't get distracted by the fans in the stands or the atmosphere or stuff like that. We just have to remember that our coaches have put us in a good situation and they've taught us everything we need to know, and we got to stick to that and just basically just go back to our fundamentals that they've been teaching us all these years and just play as a whole team. We got to make sure we're all connected, we're all on the exact same page so that mistakes don't happen.
Yeah, I'm sure you guys have to be ready to play these Tigers again. And come state playoff time, if you guys do face them, what are some things you can do differently to get the win next time around?
We just got to, basically the whole team just has to be in the game. Our sideline was kind of dead the other night. We just have to make sure those guys are behind us, backing us up, and rooting us on whenever we're out in the field. And offense and defense, we have to be connected as one, because without defense, offense can't get on the field. Without offense, defense will be on the field the entire game, and we'll get gas and we'll be winded. We just basically have to be on the same page and make sure we're doing all of our stuff that we're assigned to do and listen to our coaches, basically.
Yeah, tonight you face off against Rogers Heritage. What is the defense doing to prepare for the War Eagle offense, and what have you seen out of the film?
Yeah. We switched up our scheme a little bit, and we've basically just been watching film about their O-line. Their O-line's really big, and we have to make sure that we have to get into our gap on time, and if those linemen get on us, they're going to be really hard to get off of us. So we have to make sure that we're doing our rip moves or our block shedding, stuff like that. And then they have two really good backs that are really quick. We have to make sure we keep them inside the tackles, make sure they don't break out into open space.
Billy, good luck tonight.
Thank you.
Now, switching sides, one of the key components on offense has been Micah Seawood. Faced with an early injury this season, Micah sat out much of preseason as a precaution for conference play. This past Friday, the Wildcats were dealt several injuries, including Jay Burns, Jadarius Brown, Jack Strubing, and Micah Seawood. We are standing by to give you the update on Micah and whether or not this injury will affect the rest of the season. Take a look.
As a senior, wide receiver Micah Seawood was set back by an injury earlier this football season. Yet instead of putting his head down and pouting about it, he decided that he would become that one encourager for the Wildcats on the sidelines.
Going into the season, he's had a hamstring issue that we've been dealing with, but just the adversity that he's going through and seeing him grow through that as a man has been fun to watch. And yeah, when he hits full stride and he's the Micah Seawood that we saw this summer, the sky's the limit. Everybody knows his ability. So when they see him engaged and encouraging, you know, that energy is it spreads like wildfire.
Micah Seawood's leadership has been encouraged by last year's wide receivers coach Dustin Helmkamp, as well as this year's new coach, Houston Pruitt.
Both two great coaches. Coach Pruitt came in beginning of the summer. Nobody knew who he was, and now he's just a part of the family now. Just brought him in, doing well, teaching us what to do, what not to do. I just love him for that. Even though I'm not, like, on the field, my coaches told me you still have to be a teammate. You still have to be that leader. I'm a senior now. I can't be the one in the background just lollygagging. I have to be the one standing up telling everybody to be okay. The game's going fine. I have to be that one, be that true leader.
As a senior, Seawood displays a good mix of staying focused during the game as well as encouraging his teammates. One fan also knows the potential that he possesses.
I think as soon as Micah returns that he'll just be in another threat for the opposing team and another receiver for our quarterback to throw to. All the younger juniors, sophomores, they look up to him as like a role model, and he's just someone they can look up to.
He's just he's a great leader. You know, he understands his role. He comes in and works hard every day, and going through this injury, again, it's just more adversity that he knows that he'll get through. And when we do get him back full stride, it's gonna be something special.
Although he's still not 100%, Micah Seawood is a game changer for these Wildcats. And when he does come back fully healthy, the league better watch out for this explosive star. For WCSN, I'm Nick Luttrell.
Tune in tonight to find out how the injuries will affect the Wildcats this season, or if we are back on track at 100% looking to prove something tonight. We are going to take one last quick commercial break, but coming up next, Coach Wood helps us break down Rogers' heritage. You're watching the Wildcat Sports Network.
At some point, a line has to be drawn.
No!
For us, that line is only delivering within 5 minutes of our stores, so your sandwich arrives freaky fresh. It's nothing personal. It's because sandwich.
Hometown. That word still means something here. It means we're neighbors. We do the right thing. We care about your family. And you deserve the very best every time you walk in the front door. Harps, hometown fresh.
You can love where you live and play at an apartment community managed by Lindsay Management Company. Affordable apartments with awesome amenities, including clubhouses, fitness center, pools, tennis and basketball courts, and playgrounds at select locations. Many locations also include golf privileges, business centers, game rooms, tanning beds, whirlpools, saunas, and resort-style swimming pools. View rates, photos, and apply online at lindsaymanagement.com.
Our 30 minutes or less ER service pledge means faster care. And because we're full-service hospitals, a lot more care if you need it. Less waiting, faster care. At Northwest Health System, Bentonville and Springdale.
If you absolutely, positively want the best heating and air company in Northwest Arkansas, then you need to call Absolute Heat and Air with over 73 years of combined experience. Their technicians are fully licensed and insured, background checked, and drug tested, so you can absolutely trust Absolute Heat and Air. They offer $49 service calls all year long, 24/7, 365, the absolute best value around. Call Absolute Heat and Air or visit us online.
Try the 3-in-3 meal at Slim Chickens. Three hand-breaded chicken tenders paired with three perfectly fried wings, shaken in your choice of house flavors. Served with fries, Texas toast, and a medium drink. Slim Chickens. Fresh, delicious chicken.
Here at HAR-BER, athletes make things run much smoother.
Need a runner.
Two seconds slower than the last time, Chris. Come on.
Welcome back, and here to help us bring this show to a close is Coach Wood. Coach, tonight you look to rebound on the road against Heritage. How much of a confidence booster will it be for your guys to win tonight?
Well, I mean, just the big key is just to play cleaner football in all three phases. And, you know, when we put all three phases together, we're a really good ball club. And when we're not putting all three phases together, We're just in the middle pack with everybody else. So tonight's about execution. It's about doing what we do and be cleaner, put some good film out there. And our guys are going to do a good job tonight. They're going to play hard. They love playing. They love playing this game together as one unit. I just enjoy watching them play.
Now, in any sport, there's always upsets. How do you keep your team motivated and energetic to come out juiced and ready, just as in any other team?
Well, I mean, I just tell them more than anything, it's high school football. And, you know, 90% of this football team's never going to play football again after this season, after they graduate high school. Very few go on to college. And you just need to enjoy the moments. Enjoy playing tonight. Don't worry about what's down the road. You've worked hard. So have fun playing. You're a high school kid playing a high school sport. Enjoy it.
Now, last Friday, we saw lots of cats go down with injuries. The biggest one is sophomore Jack Strubing. Can you give us a little bit of an update on how he's doing?
Yeah, he ended up with a season-ending injury. He broke his ankle. He had surgery on Tuesday to fix that. It looks like we're on about a 4 to 5 month recovery process and some ligament stuff and some. He's going to come back just fine. But his sophomore year has come to a conclusion on the football field of playing. But Jack's such a good young man, and he's got a great heart, and he'll be back stronger than ever for his junior year. I think it's a great reminder. Each rep matters, and you never know when that last rep could end that season. And for Jack, I mean, it's just an unfortunate fluke deal, how he broke it. But he's doing real well, and he'll get back from this, be better than ever.
That's good. Now, the guys were Jay Burns and Darius Brown, who played with Cass in their arms in that game, as well as Micah Seawood, who looked good in the first half but didn't return in the second. Can you give us an update on them? Are we going to be playing safe tonight and not playing them, or are they expected to play?
Jay Burns will still be. I mean, he's just dealing with kind of a bruise within his hand. Mm-hmm. JB Brown, he'll be out tonight as we go in and get that thumb fixed. Should be back by next week. We've got Micah Seawood, he's just got that hamstring still nagging him a little bit, but he got in, saw the doctor on Monday. I think they've got a really good plan moving forward. I think he could be back on the field within 2 weeks. And so, we're sitting, even though we got guys banged up, it's not longevity except for Jack. So everyone else should be back tonight or within the week.
Yeah. Now back to Heritage, what can we expect out of the War Eagles?
You know, I think they do a really good job of knowing who they are and what they are. And their coaches aren't, they're sound defensively. They're teaching them the game the right way. They play extremely hard. Offensively the same way. So they're just instilling in them with a new coach, discipline, and do your job. And that's what they do. I got a lot of respect for it because he's not trying to manipulate the system just to find a way to win a game. He's really using the system to teach the kids how to play the game the right way, and it'll turn for them. I mean, it's been a rough start for them, but you can tell they're doing things the right way.
What do the Wildcats need to do to walk away with a win tonight?
Well, I mean, I'm kind of repetitive on this, but I think everybody understands now the magnitude of this. Can't turn the ball over. You got a winning kicking game. And when we're doing that, we're a pretty good old football team. When we struggle in those areas, it can be a tough night for us. Offensively, we've got to execute and be clean. Can't have three and outs, stuff like that.
Coach, thanks for joining us, and good luck tonight.
Appreciate it.
That's all the time we have for tonight's show. Be sure to tune in next week with Donald Tucker and Zach Arnes as they co-host WCSN for Rivalry Week, and bring you one episode you won't want to miss. For Superintendent Dr. Jim Rollins and Athletic Director Wayne Stelick, I'm Nick Luchel. Up next is kickoff. We'll see you next week.
So what do you do when you fall down?
And folks, that is going to conclude tonight's game against the Fayetteville Purple Dogs.
Get back up. Everybody knows to get back up.
But I tell you, there are some times in life where you fall down and you feel like you don't have the strength to get back up. The choice that we have, though, is either to give up or keep on going. It's not the end until you've given up.
Hey, Nate. How's life?
I don't know. It's all right. I've been dealing with some things like every human being and really didn't sleep much last night. I'm sorry. That's fine. I just think I need a little me time. I just think I need a little free time. A little break from the shows and the bus ride, yeah. That's when I start to get anxious. That's when my thoughts can be dangerous. That's when I put on my makeup and drown in self-hatred. Forget what I'm saying and... Where'd the beat go? Drums came in, you ain't see that coming. Hands on my head, can't tell me nothing. Got a taste of the fame, it'll pump my stomach. Throw it back up like I don't want it. Wipe my face, clean up my vomit. OCD, trying to push my buttons. I said don't touch it, now y'all done it. Take a look at the benefits. Nothing to matter with, I can never be delicate. My irrelevant, that depends how you measure it. Take a measurement to back it up and give me the evidence. Pretty evident, dependable can never be tentative. I'm a gentleman, depending on the fact that you're genuine. Pretty elegant, but not afraid to tell you to get it. Grip proper etiquette, I keep it to myself when I celebrate. It's that time again.
Better grab your balloons and invite your friends. Seatbelts back on, yeah, strap them in. Look at me, everybody, I'm smiling big. On a road right now that I can't predict. Tell me tone that down, but I can't resist. Y'all know that sound, better raise your fist. The search begins, I'm back, so enjoy the trip.
To the corner, he's got a man open. Touchdown, HAR-BER Wildcats.